Hey guys, in this series of tutorials, we'll show you how you can get started with using the Untitled Studio mobile apps. So we'll be taking a look at how you can record, edit, and apply effects to your first audio track. We'll also have a look at our more immediate use, which could be the one of instantly importing a bass track or backing track, and then recording vocals or instruments over it. And you know, this could be an very common use for rappers or instrumentalists, which immediately want to make music but don't wish to dive into the multitrack features. We'll also have a look at adding virtual instruments and playing them using the program's built-in controllers, such as the piano or the drums. Finally, we also have a look at how you can save your project and export your tracks to various formats, and how you can share it on Songtree, the music collaboration platform. So let's begin. At the first opening, Ntrack shows this Start Your Song menu, with which you can choose how to start your song. For example, you can start by recording an audio track, by composing a MIDi track for a virtual instrument, and so on. At the bottom left, you'll see the transport bar, in which you'll find the recording button, the play button, the rewind button, and the loop timeline section, which allows you to play back sections of your song. At the bottom right, you'll see the main toolbar, in which you'll find the main menu, the share song button, the add track button, the mixer button, and various others like undo, redo, and so on. Note that on smaller devices, you may need to scroll the toolbar a little in order to see all the buttons. In between, you'll see the main panel, where you'll find the time status, start and end points for the current timeline selection, the project's BPM and time signature values, as well as a switch to enable the metronome. On the top of the timeline, you can see the time axis, which can be useful for editing, as well as keeping track of where you are in your song. You can also enable the grid over here by tapping on this grid icon and choosing the time unit you want to use.